you very much for the great presentation. Next is Santa Catalina from Monterey, California.
Fortunately. 28 nuclear incidents that have been declassified. To cover a few of the worst incidents, let's take a look at August 5, 1950, where in Fairfield, California, a plane carrying nuclear material crashed and detonated during an emergency landing that killed 19 people. On March 11, 1958, a B-47 plane accidentally fired an unarmed nuclear weapon that landed and detonated near Florence, South Carolina. This accident left behind property damages and ground injuries. But the worst happened on September 18, 1980. A Titan II maintenance crew in Damascus, Arkansas, ran into what they thought were minor complications, which hours later resulted in 21 casualties and one fatality. Most of the other incidents happened while the weapons and radioactive materials were being transported by plane.
Fortunately, none of those accidents resulted in a full-scale nuclear catastrophe, like, for example, the meltdown of Chernobyl's nuclear reactor on April 26, 1986. Nor do they compare to the crisis that happened in Fukushima when a tsunami destroyed the nuclear reactors on March 11, 2011. It's shocking that we haven't experienced an accident like Ukraine or Japan after learning about these documented accidents.
It really is surprising. After analyzing and witnessing the damage done by the atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, we have come to the conclusion that the existence of nuclear weapons poses an unacceptable threat to humanity.
So, what can we offer as a solution that works towards paving the path to complete nuclear weapon disarmament? In our research, we discovered that the NPT rests upon three pillars: nonproliferation, disarmament, and the peaceful use of nuclear energy. When we took a closer look at the NPT, we thought that a majority of the treaty was geared towards nonproliferation. In our solution, we decided to rename the NPT as the NPDT, Non-Proliferation and Disarmament Treaty, in order to stress disarmament first and foremost. Just like the NPT, our solution is modeled on three pillars of our own: decommissioning, disassembling, education, and reducing transportation.
Each pillar requires us to make an amendment to the original NPT. Each hopes to develop clear guidance for the management and transportation of current nuclear weapons and works towards properly educating those who must handle the weapons and fissile materials.
The first pillar of action requests that the International Atomic Energy Agency determine the number of years that is safe for nuclear weapons to be in active service before it becomes mandatory that they be decommissioned and disassembled. This amendment will be made to the NPT's third article in order to make it more specific and clear in its intentions. The goal here is double-sided. In one way, we achieve a definite and consistent path towards disarmament, as states must be dismantling their weapons after a set number of years. In order to replace a nuclear weapon, the state must complete an extensive application. The goal of this application is to ensure that states seeking to restock or acquire a new nuclear weapon is absolutely capable of controlling their facilities and fissile materials.
This leads to the second pillar of our solution, which focuses on the education requirements for those who would be expected to work with any form or connection to nuclear weapons and fissile materials. This pillar is one that requires and explicitly details nuclear weapon safety regulation courses, as well as the fulfillment of at least a vocational school education or an international equivalent. These requirements will serve to reduce the risk of human error when handling nuclear weapons and their radioactive components. Men and women alike who are expected to work with, near, or around nuclear weapons must be properly trained in the health risks that the weapons pose. They must show the competence by passing a series of examinations that prove the capabilities to to properly and carefully handle the materials and maintenance involved with nuclear weapons. Such examinations will test the comprehension of their native language and English, and full knowledge of sciences such as biology, chemistry, and physics.
The third pillar addresses the material, the methods and safety of fissile material transportation. Due to the shocking number of incidents that have been released by just the United States Department of Defense, the transportation of any fissile materials will be limited to land and aquatic means. This amendment will be part of the new safety regulations detailed in the article described by Pillar 2. This pillar works towards making the spread of nuclear weapons in any context difficult. In conjunction with this limitation, nuclear weapons will be prohibited from being within 50 miles or 80.5 kilometers of any non-military residential land. This here is a representation of that distance using two nuclear reactors as examples. The goal of these combined solutions ultimately work towards reducing the potential risk a nuclear weapon imposes on human societies and the environment. By keeping nuclear weapons on the ground and reducing the means of transportation, they become more and more inconvenient for states to reproduce. Ideally, over time, they will lose their value. They will lose their value and appeal and initial appeal. These pillars combined would serve to be the foundation of what directs the movement of nuclear weapon disarmament. After studying the various consequences of nuclear explosions, it is in all of our best interest to support and promote the basis of the humanitarian initiative. There is no doubt that the existence of nuclear weapons poses and threatens the existence of humanity and of planet Earth. What do we as a planet value more? Our lives or these destroyers? There seems to be a battle between the existence of nuclear weapons and mankind. And there is no doubt that nuclear weapons and people cannot coexist forever. Right now, it seems like nuclear weapons are winning this fight. However, we can join groups such as ICANN and become social leaders, advocates,